Hello student. So today I'm going to discuss some more operator that can be used in MySQL. Okay. Now today I'm going to discuss the in operator. The in operator is can be used in place of or operator, and it is used to check a single value from a list of value. Okay. That means we are going to use the in operator in place of or operator. Okay, now try to write down one statement, SQL statement, where we are going to use the in operator. That is select all from student where grade in A1 comma B1. Okay, so select all from student where grade in A1 comma B1. So as because we are going to use the in operator in place of or operator, it will check both these conditions. Here we are not using any type of relational operator. We shall skip from this statement as because we are using the in operator. Okay. So what we want, we have to display the name of the student whose grade is A1 or B1. Okay, so this is how we use the in operator in place of or operator where the relational operators are not used. Okay, so you look at the figure number 12.37 of your book. So there you notice 5 rows are selected where these both grades are present, A1 and B2 grades are present. So it will display the name of the student whose grade is A1 or B1. Now you can use the not operator along with the in operator. How? So here after the grade, you use not, where grade not in, suppose A1, A2, B1, B2. Okay, so when you write this statement using the not operator, it will display the name of the students who are not belongs to A1 or A2 or B1 or B2. It will display those students whose grade are not in A1, A2, B1 or B2. That means by using the not operator in operator, you can not specify this condition. That means you don't want to display the name of the student whose grade is A1 or A2, B1 or B2. Okay, so you look at so there is no figure in your book, so it will not display the name of the student whose grade is A1, A2 or B1 or B2. Okay. Now, next, I am going to discuss working with null. Do you know what is null? Null means no value. Working null. Working with null means null means no value. Okay. Now, sometimes what happen? At the time of data entry in a table, the data entry operator don't know the exact value to enter in a particular field name. Okay, so that he jump or he skip that field and jump to an another field. Okay, that means null value doesn't mean that there is no value. It has value, but at the time of data entry, the data entry operator don't know the value what to enter inside that field name. So that's why he skip that field without entering any type of value. That type of field fill up with null value. Okay, now we are going to use this null operator in our SQL statement. Okay, so there are two operators. First is null. The second one is not null. So these two operators which can be used in our SQL statement. Okay, so that's why I am going to discuss it with the example. With example, how to use it. Okay, so as well, the query is select roll number, comma, student name, comma, student name from student where grade is null. Okay, so when you write this SQL statement, that is select roll number, student name from student where grade is null. That means from the student label, I want to display the roll number and the student's name whose grade is null. That means in the grade field, no values are entered. At the time of data entry, no values are entered in the grade field. So, by using this statement, you can display the name of the student whose grade is filled up with null value. Okay, so you look at the figure number 12.38, there you notice only one row is selected whose grade is null. Or you can write is not null. So where if I write grade, where grade is, if I use not null, then it will display the name of the student whose grade field is not null. That means there are some values. That means at the time of data entry, the data entry operator enter the grade of the student. That may be A1, A2, B1, B2 like that. Okay, so it will display the name of the students whose grades are not null. So look at the figure number 12.39. There you notice many rows are selected and the name of the students are displayed and whose grade are not null. Okay, now this is the use of null and not null. I think all of you clear what is null value. Okay, null value means the value which is not entered in a particular field at the time of data entry, and that type of field fill up by null value. Okay, now the next thing is operator precedence. Operator precedence. The precedence of operator tells you the sequence of evaluation if more than one operator is present in an expression. Okay, already we discussed different type of operators which can be used in MySQL statement. Okay, now if you use more than operators, okay, many operators in a SQL statement, then that at the time of evaluation of the operator, the computer follow the operator precedence. That means which operator evaluate first and which operator evaluated in the next time. Okay, that means it is like the Bodmer's rule that we use in our mathematics at the time of simplification. Okay, so simplification method, we use the Bodmer's rule. So according to that rule, we follow the precedence of operator. Okay, like that. So when you use the multiple operators in your SQL statement, then the computer follow the precedence of operator. That means which operator execute first and which one to execute next. Okay, so for that there is a table in your book, that is table number 12.4. So there you notice many operators are used and some are new for you, which are not used in our class 10 syllabus. Okay, so you look, there are 15 operators. Okay, and they are used from high to low. That means high precedence to low. Okay, so first number one is not, after that number two is unary, after that number three or number four, you look multiple, divide, division and modulus operator. Okay, so these are the mathematical operator. Now same type of operator whose precedence are same, then these are evaluated from left to right. That means when the operators are evaluated, that is evaluated from left to right. So the first operator, if you use some operator whose precedence values are same, then it will evaluate from left to right. Okay, so this is the operator precedence. So you look at the board and there you notice the table contain the different type of operators according to our precedence from high to low. Okay, so student, that's all for today. Thank you.